Hello there. In this video, I'm going to show you a very simple example of a loop, a loop in Go. So let me show you that right away. And let's write a small program. There we go. Code test.go for a loop. So maybe this is zoomed enough. Package main as usual. Function main, and there we go. So what you have to know is that in Go, for is the only loop construct. In other languages you have while, but for is the only one in Go. What you need is an initializer, a condition expression, and a post statement. So this is the way you do it. Here is the initializer that we declare at zero. Here is the condition. Let's say we want it to go until 10. And here is the post statement, the one that will do the incrementation of the loop. So there we go. Voilà. So let's say I want to print number 0 to 10. 0 to 10, and I don't want to do it this way. FMT println 1, FMT copy paste, copy paste, copy paste, copy paste, and change it there. This one won't be efficient. This is why we will use a loop to do it for us. So here I'm going to put FMT print ln, and I'm going to put the I that's declared there. Let's save this and let's see what happened if we test it. Go run test.go. There we go. I have the 10 numbers printing. Let's put it at 5. So for reading purposes, let me save it again. Control L. There we go. So as you can see, the action repeated itself 5 times and while changing the variable. Now, know that there's actually another way to write this. You don't have to put the I here, the initializer. You can put it here. Call 0. And you can also put the incrementation inside the loop. This can be useful sometimes. Know that you have this flexibility. So this is the way it's written. And does it give you exactly the same result? Yes, it does. So that's it for the example of a loop. You have to create your own programs and play with them. This is with this tool, with this very powerful tool, you can do very many things. So I'll let you to it, and good luck for your exercises. See you until the next video.